friends, my name is Harvansh and thanks for watching my other videos where you was learning about the semantic and SCCM technology. So my few of the friends giving me feedback like I started my videos after building a lab. So few people are facing the trouble how they can build a lab in the VMware. So this video is about to how you can install your server in the VM. So when you needed a lab, obviously you need a VM and there the server should be installed. So this video is about to how I can install Windows Server 2K12 in the VMware. So let me start this video and hope you will learn completely how you gonna start your creating a virtual lab. So you just open your VMware. First you can install your VMware. You can download it from internet and better go to the torrent so you will get the license version as well. Okay, so here is already I installed my VMware and I am going to install 2K12 server. So once you open your VMware, you will be having the home page and here is the create new virtual machine. So before starting this video, I want to show you something like how you can download your server evolution version. You go to the Microsoft site evolution center and here you will get all the latest servers, Windows 2K19 server, 16 server and 2K12 server. Okay, so I have downloaded already 2K12 server and I kept it here. It's my 2K12 server. I'm going to show you how we can install the 2K12 server. And same way, if you want like 2K16 or 2K19, so you can follow the same process. There is a nothing changed to for the installation. So now you can go to the home page and click here new virtual machine. Click on next and here is a installer disk. So just browse what you downloaded your server version. So I have my the server version 2K12 as I showed you. It's all here 2K12. So just I am clicking open and click on next and here it detecting the Windows version. So you can just select it Windows server 2K12. So where it is, it's not reflecting here. Let me import the another image. So might be there is a problem with my installation. So I have kept it here in the software under the software 2K12 ISO and let me click on next. And here is a name it asking what you want. So you can give the name and that name will show like that here it's showing. So you can give anything name. I'm giving like as it is. And my the installation VM installation where the VM path this OS will be kept there the source file after the installation. Okay. So let me go to the some folder in this computer. And I do have my drive here and here is a lab image I was created 2K12. So you create a folder where should be the enough space and like the more than 30-40 GB should be there. So it will not be causing any issue in future. Select it and next. And here is a 60 GB. So however you want, like 60 GB, 100 GB, 200 GB, it based on your lab environment how much you are going to use it. So you can do the first option, you can select it. So it will be like it will not split that VHDK file. So when VM is installing, it creating the VHDK file, VM file it will create. So split into the multiple file. So you can choose anything. I am just taking for example, it's a single file. So now click on next and just finished. Say okay, yes. And now my the installation will be starting here. And let's wait the for screen. Okay, so now screen came Windows Server 2012 R2 and click on Next. Click on Installed. Okay, so guys, here is a 2-3 options like the core installation and the GUI. So we are not going to the server core installation. Core installation is something like it will be work on the CLI mode only. So it will not show you the GUI, but we need to work on the GUI mode only. So I am selecting the GUI mode. You can use the standard edition and the data center edition. So I am going to take it the standard edition. So just click on Next and accept the license. Click on Next. And here is a upgrade and the custom installation. So we are not going to upgrade our server, and just we are going to fresh installation. So fresh installation, you go with the custom installation. So here is an option to make the drives. So if you want to create two drives, like you want 30 GB two drives, okay, you can split it here. Or if you want just one drive only, so you can keep it here. Like, let me show you how you can create the two drives. So I can give like a 40 GB and the 20 GB. I have the 60 GB memory size. Even though you can increase it because we are in the VM, so easily you can increase this hard disk size also. So 40 GB means is 4096 and apply this, and now it will be like is remaining. Oh, sorry. So let me delete this and I can create it new. It will be like 40960. So now it will be the 40 GB. Yes. Okay, so now I have the one drive. It will not exactly the 40 GB, it little less, because it will be for few memory will be the reserved, and the another drive is a 20 GB. So let me create, and if you want, if you have some more hard disk, you can create one more and the one more. So I'm creating only the two drive. Now in which drive you want to install the OS, select it and click on Next. And now your OS is going to start. So file copies is done and get ready for the installation. So now installation is going on. It will take few times, like 10-15 minutes, and this server will installed. So let me pause this video. Hey guys, so now it is completed 94%, and in this screen no need to do anything, just let it be and watch continue. So installing features is done, and now installing update that is done, and now it finishing up stage. Now it will take 10 seconds to reboot it, or better we can also reboot this. So now this server is installed and it's getting ready. So guys, in my the next video I will show you after the installation how you can configure your VM server with a compatible with the VMware. Like the IP address, how you gonna assign it. So please watch the my next video. It will very helpful, because few people are doing the mistake when they build the lab. They create a server and start building the labs, like the SQL server and their own application, like the SCCM, Symantec or any other application. So if you are installing, then your the static IP, your dynamic IP will be there and static IP will not be there. So we are gonna configure now the static IP, and when we configure the static IP and which IP it will take it and how it will get connected to your physical machine. So let it run. I will show you. Okay, so what is the status? Let's see. Here it's showing I finished the installation. Okay, I don't want, because it asking to install the VM client, but my server is not ready, so I don't want to install VM client on my machine. So once the server will working fine, then I will install my the VM client. Okay, so here it asking automatically taking the administrator name, and it asking for the password. Just give the password twice, which easily you can remember it. If you forgot the password, and there is no option to reset the administrator, so please keep remember or make a note your password. So now it's finalizing your settings. Okay, so it will take just a few seconds, and the server will be ready. We can wait till that time. It's finalizing, it's taking little time. I don't want to skip this part. Just we can wait few more seconds. Okay, so now it finalized, and let's see what screen will come out. Okay, so now my server is ready. And I can click here on this. This is like Control L delete, and it will give you the password window. So now I am putting my password. Okay, so it's getting ready. Okay guys, so now my the server installation is done, and it asking for the network. Yes, so now directly it will be having the internet access. You can see it here, and it will be on the dynamic IP that is coming from DHCP. So let me set the resolution first, so my screen will be looks good. So you just right click, go to the property, and I can set up my resolution screen. It's 1366786. So my, it's up to your the laptop resolution, how your screen size, based on that you can set it, and it will looks like something fit for your screen. So now my server is installed, and if you want to check the host name, you can go here, properties, and this part also you have to change it before going to install your lab. Okay, or I can show you how you can change this host name here. So change the properties, click change, and put it here the name. So I am putting like a lab. Click OK. It's going to apply. You must need to restart your computer. Click OK. Yes, and restart now. So this machine will restart, and it will be ready to work. Now your host name also change. Okay, so it will on immediately, as it is a VM. It's so fast. And I can show you here in this video only how you can configure, like your to increase your RAM, So go to the memory, and here you can increase your RAM size how much you want it. So just I want only the 2 GB, and if you want to change the processor, want to be more in that processor, you can change it up to 2, but you have to shut down your VM. And if you want to increase your hard disk, yes, you can do it. So, but you need to shut down first your VM and then you can do it. So here you can see in it, if you want to increase your RAM, so how you can do it here. So now this my VM is ready and I can able to log in. Okay guys, so next okay, first I can show you here control panel. Go to the control panel and verify your IP address. So before going to start your lab environment, you just need to be careful for some things, like the host name should be changed and IP address should be the static. So go here and click on property, and in the IPv4, so here it's automatically assigned. So don't keep like a automatically, it will be causing an issue when you are running the your lab. Okay, so I will show you how this IP address is going to change in the my next video. Okay guys, so thank you for watching this video. Hope you learned how you can build your server. In the same process, you can install even your Windows 7, Windows 10 and your server 2K12, 2K14, 16 or the 19. Okay guys, so thank you for watching this video and start building your lab.